Welcome back to the channel. This is the Action Figure Grader, and I alluded to this in a video a week or two ago, but a friend of mine and Patreon supporter, Jason W., put together a really cool spreadsheet, and it took him a very long time to put this together, probably several months, but he basically went through AFA's population report for loose graded vintage Star Wars figures and put together a spreadsheet for every single variant for every single character. And it lays out the grades for each character and each variant as of July 2024. So obviously with every figure that AFA grades from here on out, this spreadsheet's not going to be updated, but I think it's a great snapshot to give you an idea of the population report across different grades for some of our favorite figures. And there's some pretty cool trends that I wanted to go through. I'm not going to go through everything, obviously, it would take forever, but shout out to Jason W. For putting this together. It took him many, many hours over the course of several months because AFA limits the number of searches that you can do. And so he had to kind of be patient and do it over the course of a very long time. So thank you, Jason, for putting this together and for sending it to me. It was a really incredible spreadsheet, and it's a great resource that I have put up on my Patreon page for those of you that are interested in it. Let's take a closer look. I'm not going to go through everything, but this just kind of gives you an idea of the types of information that he put out there. So for every single character, A through Z, as well as numbered characters like 21B, 4LOM, 8D8, he went through AFA's population report and shows you every single variation for them. And it's just pretty wild to see some of the cool things that are out there. A lot of the errors, I'll say this, I'm going to highlight a few of them, but if you have any error figures that have like two right legs or two left arms, or, you know, there's a 4LOM, two right arms, things like that, reversed legs. If you have any of those, you might want to consider sending those to AFA because there are very few of them on the census as you would expect. So for example, 21B, two right legs, there's only two of them that have ever been graded. 4LOM, two right arms, only one of those has ever been graded. And so just that kind of thing, I think it's worth noting that because if you have any error figures, you have bragging rights, right, for that kind of thing. The other thing I'll say is if you have any Uzes, the Turkish bootlegs that are complete, you can probably consider sending those in if you're into grading that kind of stuff because there are very few of those on the AFA population report. So, for example, the AT-AT driver, SB Products, SB Products is Uze. It's the Turkish Uze bootlegs. There's only been, you know, three or four of those. And then there was the unglued, unpainted, meaning the non-sonic welded overstock. There's 11 of those on the census. But in terms of actual complete Uze SB Products AT-AT drivers, there's only been four that have been graded total. So that's a pretty incredible number. The other thing I'll mention is, as we go through this, you'll see that consistently, Spanish PBP and POC figures. There are very few of those on the census across every single character. And we've talked about that in the channel, right? Is that most likely Spanish figures get sent to UKG for grading instead of AFA because most of those Spanish figures are over in Europe. So just out of ease of transport, less risk of them being lost in shipping, that UKG gets all the Spanish figures. So as a result, Spanish figures on the AFA population report are very few. And here's another example of that, that the AT-AT driver, only three have been graded for the Spanish AT-AT driver. So that's an interesting side note there as well. The other thing I'll mention is a lot of Last 17. When you look at the breakdown between 85, 85 plus, 90, 90 plus, or less than 85, you'll see that, for example, the A-Wing pilot, there's been 393 loose graded A-Wing pilots. But the interesting thing is that of those 393, at least as of July, most of them are 85 and above. And so, for example, the A-Wing palette, all of them that have ever been graded have been 393. But if you look at the number of them that have graded 85 and above, the number is 303. So 303 of the A-Wing palette are 85 and above out of the 393. So what does that tell you? To me, that tells you that it makes no sense. If you want to buy a loose graded A-Wing pilot, it makes no sense to buy it less than 85 grade because there's just so many of them out there, right? And so I just thought that was an interesting side note that three quarters of the A-Wing pilots that have been submitted for loose grading are 85 and above. So, and that's true for a lot of the last 17. I'm not going to go through all these, but it's just an interesting thing. One other interesting note that Jason said is that for the standard Hong Kongs and Taiwans and things like that, for standard characters, common characters, when you compare those to the no COOs, which again, those are like usually on Palatoys or Tri-Logos, the no COOs are very few in number, but the ones that have been graded are very consistently high grade. So while AFA may get less of those no COOs, when they do get submitted, they're almost always 85s and 90s. So I thought that was an interesting note. The Cloud Car Pilot, Spanish PBP, which is a very rare figure. There's several different variations for the Spanish PBP Cloud Car Pilot, but overall, there's only been 19 of them ever submitted to AFA for grading. So, that kind of ties back into the point I've already made, is that Spanish figures are very tough to find. Again, going back to SB products, which are Uzes, for the Death Star droid, there's only been 10 graded by AFA. And for the Death Squad Commander, remember the Disco Boots Spanish figure, there's only been one that has been submitted to AFA, whereas I'm sure on UKG there's been more than one. And that's a pretty rare character, a very rare variant. But I thought that was interesting that for the Disco Boots, they call it the Thick Boot Soles Spanish PBP. It's really the Spanish, I think it's a Spanish puck because, well, no, it's a no COO. So that is a Spanish PBP. So there's only been one that has been submitted to AFA. Again, another very interesting note. Look how many Darth Vader variants have been submitted over across all of the different Darth Vaders. So again, another very interesting side note there. Only 27 Top Toys, only 8 different SB products, Turkish Uze bootlegs have been submitted. And, so there's been a number of different variants for the Taiwan only is one that I've got in my collection. That's the Toll Toys example. There's been only 6 of those, and mine's, I think, an AFA 80, and none of them have ever hit an AFA 85. So that's kind of a cool note there. Again, I'm not going to go through all these. You can go through it yourself if you're interested. I put a Google Drive link on my Patreon page, but just very, very cool to see all of this information. Again, going back to the error figures, the Emperor 2 left legs, there's only been one of those submitted. So if you have one of those, that's probably worth submitting to AFA if you got one. And let's see what else we got here. General Maydeen, the Lily Letty. I was surprised to see how few of those have ever been submitted to AFA for the Lily Letty. I've got a CAS 90. But you almost want to send it in to AFA to see what it gets, because there's only been 22 of them that have ever been submitted. Only 5 of them are AFA 85s and only 190. So that's one where you might want to I might want to consider cross grading that, taking it out of the CAS case, sending it in to AFA, just given that, you know, mine got a 90 with CAS, even if it drops in grade, because we talked about that CAS tends to grade a little looser. Even if it drops to an 85 plus or an 85, it would be one of 6 or 7 that have ever been graded. So I thought that was kind of interesting. Just a really interesting data analysis for all of these. And Jason, I think, mentioned that there's been, let's see here, across all different variants for all different characters in total, as of July, there have been 198,374 loose graded vintage Star Wars figures. And so that's kind of a crazy stat when you think about it, how many of them there are within the population report, at least as you know, Jason had to kind of do it manually. So maybe he's missing some, but I doubt it. It's a pretty comprehensive analysis. The R2-D2 droid factory, there's only been 130 of those graded across all grades. So that's a good one. That's fairly common that if you have one, it's probably worth grading because there's only 130 of them total on the population report. There were some other ones I wanted to talk about here, if you bear with me. Let's see here. The Jawa. Look how many different Jawa variants there are. I mean, there are a ton of variants. There's been 3,053 across all variants, but there's some very rare ones. The other interesting thing is that the vinyl cape Jawa, the one that's super expensive, there's been a lot of them that have been submitted. There's 580 of them on the census, and of the 580, there are 396 that are graded AFA 85 or above. So that's another one you might want to consider only getting an AFA 85 if you have the money for it. I mean, that's an expensive figure, but there's only, you know, the vast majority of them have been graded AFA 85 or above for just the standard Hong Kong vinyl cape Jawa. And again, that comes down to demand, right? That demand outstrips supply, but the supply is actually pretty plentiful when you look at some of them. But some of the other more rare variants that I was surprised by how many of them there were, the Toll Toys Empire Strikes Back vinyl cape Jawa, there's been 99 of them submitted, which I would argue is a pretty big number. That's a big number for of what we always have talked about being a very rare character. Again, another error figure, two right legs. There's only been one of those submitted. But you know, obviously most of the different variants relate to the stitch on the robe, and there are been a ton of different variants: dark gray stitch, dark green stitch only on sleeves. There's been two of those, and so that's pretty cool. Black stitch, that was one I did have and I sold off, and I probably shouldn't have, just given that there's only been 14 of them ever sold, or ever, excuse me, ever submitted. But I did sell mine off eventually. So anyway, just crazy. Rust stitch is one that we've talked about in the past, and there's 10 of those. And for the Lily Letty fixed hood, obviously the removable hood is a pretty rare one, but not one that we see come up regularly. There's 120 of those on the AFA population report, but the fixed hood Lily Letty, where it's actually sewn together, there's only seven of those. So that's a very, very rare one there. So yeah. Anyway, that is kind of it. I wanted to check out the Yak Faces. So Yak Face is one where I always say, hey, there's a ton of those on the census. Don't go crazy overpaying for it. There's been 910 loose graded Yak Faces, and of that, 650 of the 910, so over two-thirds of the Yak Faces that have been submitted for loose grading are 85 and above. So that's another one you'd probably, you know, really all Last 17s kind of follow that trajectory, that if you are into Last 17 loose graded, that you probably want to get one 85 or above, just because the population of them are very, very plentiful. The PBP figure for the Sand People, this is one I've talked about and one in my own collection. There's only been six of those for the dark brown bandolier, which is what mine is. There is also a light brown bandolier Spanish PBP. There's only one of those on the census at all, so or total. So anyway, what I've learned is that for Last 17 loose graded, focus on AFA 85s. For the vinyl cape Jawa, again, if you have the money, the 85 and above seems to be where you want to go. And for Spanish PBP figures, if you happen to see one, which again, they're not very plentiful, but if you happen to see Spanish PBP figures, you'd probably want to consider getting them if they're AFA graded, because there's just so few of them. Here's another one that's in my collection, the Spanish PBP Lando Calrissian Bespin. Red brown skin, teeth, European release with the metallic blaster. That's what I have, and there's only been, let's see, they didn't mention that on mine. They just said European release, but there's only been 8 submitted and 4 with the metallic blaster. Mine actually is the metallic blaster version, even though it would fall under this red brown skin teeth European release. That's how they labeled mine, even though mine did come with the metallic blaster. So mine's actually 1 of 5, even though it's kind of mislabeled, quote unquote. The Lily Letty Lando was, there's only 25 of those total on the census. I've got one of those, AFA 80. So anyway, I just thought that was kind of a cool analysis that Jason put together. Thank you again, Jason, for doing that. I know that took you forever to put it together, but there were some pretty cool trends that we've just talked about, and hopefully you guys learned something from it. But just an awesome snapshot as to what the current population of different variants are for all of these different characters. Thank you again for watching, and I'll be back soon.